my, oh my, Ajayi.
Hello, everyone. I'm Jonathan Coachman. This is Madden NFL Football on EA Sports. Straight ahead, Jay Ajayi. Fresh off 100 yards a week ago, as it'll be the Houston Texans taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. I'll be back with you again with scores around the league at halftime. But kickoff right around the corner. Standing by to call the action, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, it's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago for the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the Houston Texans. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Eagles team as they interplay here. They come in riding high, just one loss in their last seven games.
It's a very focused team, very disciplined. They've kept the penalties to a minimum, and they're winning football games.
Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Texans, they've come in on a nice run of recent form, four wins out of five.
And the offense last week.
The holiday season is upon us. We've got the gift to the NFL as we're underway here in Week 16. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So here are the defending NFC champs on offense now. They'll be led out by their 6'5 quarterback out of North Dakota State. It's Carson Wentz.
I like this guy. And the reason I do, he tends to stand an even keel. Doesn't let too much ruffle him. He will manage the game the way it needs to be managed, take what the defense gives him, and then he can strike at times. Had a touchdown pass. Yes, he had an interception last week, but he found a way for his team to win.
Now a play fake here on first down. An interception made by Alshon Jeffery. And they get him down, but Alshon takes it across the 40-yard line. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down.
It all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. There are the numbers last week for Jay Ajayi. There isn't a coach alive who wouldn't like those numbers. Well over 100 yards and a touchdown, too.
Gardner, I think all the coaches who are in that great coaching box in the sky would take those numbers.
So dead or alive.
Either way, they would take that kind of production.
He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, that he wants to hit that 200 mark this season.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you feed me the football. And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries. Just keep giving it to him.
First and 10 now in Houston territory at the 46. On play action, Wentz. They dump off underneath to Ajayi. It's a 10-yard pickup and it moves the chains. Just the first quarter of tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. I ended up having a pretty decent ball game. If I missed him, it would have been a different story.
Pick up the 28 yards. And on this first drive, looks like they want to get that vertical passing game going early.
And And they did. And what a warning shot they just fired. If you're not going to back up and play coverage deep, we're going to attack you all game long. And once you adjust to that and you start to back off, then that opens things up underneath. A really nice start for them. Great way to get the game going.
Into the red zone for the first time. This is first and goal from about the 8.
Hey.
This is a drive. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. That gets him 3 yards closer here as it brings up second and goal. Quickly now, a look at the Eagles' offensive starters.
Back after offseason rotator cuff surgery is Alshon Jeffrey, who played with the injury all of 2017 and still caught 57 passes for 787 yards and 9 touchdowns. What makes him special? Not just his size, but his athleticism, which was on display. And a brilliant catch for the football.
Johnny Hitt, he lost the football. They give it to him right left. And the Texans say they have it. They do.
On the board. A lot of teams call from the 10-yard line in the green zone. That's your money zone. He fumbles the ball inside the money zone. You have one job, take care of the ball. That didn't happen.
And here comes the Texans now. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 from back at their own 10-yard line. On the ground, this is Lamar Miller. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. The numbers for Miller in last week's ball game, very productive. 3 touchdowns, 2 of them on the ground, 1 through the air.
And it will always be a compliment to say that a guy's got a nose for the end zone, and he sure had it last week. They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Some pressure was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Watson to throw on third and one. But he finds his man, Griffin. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. 10 yards there, good enough for a Texan first down. After getting that turnover on the first drive of the game, you'd hate to just start out the momentum, go 3 and out. They're able to avoid that there.
And we talk about complimentary football all the time, but I think it's a little bit deeper than that. Defense went out, forced a turnover, gave the ball to the offense. It's now the offense's responsibility to pay that off for them, to show respect to them. Hey, you guys got the turnover. We appreciate it. They want to continue their drive.
Down! That's what it is!
A first down carry now for Miller. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
To throw on 2nd is Watson. That's a complete to Miller. And at a 42-yard line here and brought down there. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
That was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that? 2nd and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
So 2 first downs, and that moves the ball to the 42 now, 1st and 10. They'll run it now, out of the ball. And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the 2nd half, if you've got a running back of this size, guys of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, but some of these shorter games turn into bigger runs later.
Now a run. This is Alfred Blue. The 5 yards on the play there to drive and continue.
I know flashy plays, splashy plays, as people like to call them, that attracts a lot of attention. But let's face it, when you're efficient, that can control a ball game. And I love the game plan they've got going right now.
Back-to-back five-yard gains. Didn't force the ball downfield. Picked it up on the ground.
Yeah, offensive line, they're getting it done.
They go play action here on first down. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. Just shy of the 20. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when we talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far.
Script. You go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
The Texans with the first opportunity now from the red zone. It's first and 10 from the 12. Watson hands to Miller on the draw. They showed off a nice juke to the defender before the next wave could bring him down. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
For the first time this afternoon.
Offense.
So that'll back him up 5. A bad false start penalty there. Now 2nd and 6. Good for 5. It's 3rd down. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive. It's caught. Hopkins for the Texans touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Texans have taken the early lead. Personally for him, a great opening drive. He had 3 catches, including the touchdown.
That felt like tremendous scouting, great film watching, and creating a game plan to start this off, not only to get him involved, but to send a message to the defense. You have a lot to handle in this one.
Fairbairn good with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Eagles Bengals offense making their way back out as we take a look at the playoff picture in the NFC. And with the final fortnight of games upon us, teams jockeying for position. Some of these games really starting to take enormous importance as they always do this time of year.
I like how you use fortnight.
Hey, you're impressed, don't you?
I am impressed. That means 2 weeks, if I'm not mistaken.
That does.
But how about exactly what you're talking about? Going down the stretch, how much importance is placed on these games? Look, everyone talks about every game's important. When you get to this time of year, maybe that importance gets quadruple. And that's where we are right now, to see who can make this last run, the last push to get into the playoffs.
And a look now at the defense for Houston.
The undisputed leader of Houston's defense is J.J. Watt, who's been slowed by injuries over the last two seasons, only 8 games combined. But also, he gets work done off the field. The NFL Walter Payton Man of the Year in 2017, with his work helping the flood victims of the city of Houston, raised nearly $40 million for the cause.
Flushed out right. And he can't find the receiver, and he's brought down. Zach Cunningham in there to sack him for a loss of 6.
Like the footwork back there, and I thought he did a pretty good job of evading that first wave of players. Tried to buy a little extra time out of the pocket, but in the end, oh, that was a tough one.
Yeah, winds up getting buried for the loss. Eagles coming up here on a 3rd and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack.
Pass interference. Defense.
Trying to defend the out route there. Got the PI call.
And you know what's difficult about that one? Is sometimes you want to make the undercut move and go for the football. And other times you just want to hang on the upfield shoulder and make the tackle. And you got caught in between.
And takes this one across the 35 to the 36. A gain of about 4. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on 2nd down.
So 1 quarter in the books on a cold December afternoon. 7-0 is our score, and we're back to Philadelphia after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back live with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number 2. They've got it 2nd and 6 to start things out. Here's a giant. And he'll take this one for about 4 up to the 40.
2 straight 4-yard runs, and it is steadily working the ball downfield. To me, they're staying right on schedule. 1st down, you want 4 yards or more to set up the rest of the drive. They're getting exactly that.
Yeah. after the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal.
Here we go.
20. They'll try to run with a game. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. Call it a loss of two on the play. And that'll bring up a second and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle. And he'll push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him right around four on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal.
Well, he did get a taste the previous week. He got into the end zone, tried his best to get there in this game. So
that's going to be caught for Eagles touchdown.
Successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people run the ball in the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are plays and even options involved with that.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now out comes Houston. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tumble.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Play action from Miller. Now Watson. Hauled in by Anderson left side. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
But when you hit him on the move like that, he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam. Oh, boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now a first carry for Deontay Foreman, who was lost to the Achilles injury last year. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
Down! Back 22! Back 22!
Here's Watson now on second down. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks, but doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw a completion.
Down! Back 22! Back 22!
Third and two, Watson. He's got the completion to Hopkins. He was tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. He had the touchdown on the opening drive. Now he's got a first down.
As long as you go through your proper reads and progressions, the drag route can be one of those old reliable players because usually it's good for a good chunk of yardage, as we just saw there.
And those guys like it, right? They can get the ball with a full head of steam.
Especially against man coverage, because man coverage, they're typically running away from someone and not worried about traffic coming out on the other end.
On second down, here's Miller. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and six.
That call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation. Showing the shotgun. And they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at Rushmore, hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Because the secondary, they really looked clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no good plays by the defense tonight.
23 yards on the play.
That's an excellent read right there. Sub cover one. That means it's just a single high safety. So you know if you throw the ball to the outside part of the field, help is going to be a little bit late getting there. And he puts one out there for a big-time completion.
Wentz going to lead his guys up first and 10. And he's completed all seven of his passes thus far. Now Wentz. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide it. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Going on first is Wentz. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. From the gun, it's Wentz. The hookup drive to Marquise Wilson. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes that they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect. Now Wentz on third down. Down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Third catch in his first half for him, and this one is a first down.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
They build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Wentz now 10 of 10 to start the game. How about that? As he comes up on a first and 10, they'll run it in. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Jay and Jay with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Eagles are able to cash it in for 6. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep your assignments, let him run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking. Beats good tackling on that play. And result, touchdown.
Elliott good on the extra point. And that makes the score 13-7. That time a 6-play drive. And it's capped off by a touchdown run by Jay Ajayi. Elliott now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And we focus. focus on Lamar Miller as he heads back out there and gets set to go again on offense. A 1,000-yard campaign in his sights, Charles, but needs a little bit of a kick here down the stretch to reach it.
And sometimes at this stage of the season, you're looking for that extra goal, right? That extra motivation to accomplish what you want, not just as a team, but as individuals. He's got to stretch a little bit to get there. That might be what they're talking about during the practice sessions in their meetings. Hey, we can still get this done. Let's go ahead and feed him the ball.
And the offensive line, I'm sure they're well aware of where he stands as well.
They are, and I think for them, it would be an even better accomplishment to get there now because it seems like a little bit of a reach.
Down! Blue lady! Blue lady!
Faking the give. Now Watson. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
One thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They come after him, they sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. It finds his target forward. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Down! Back 22!
On first and 10, Watson. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit. But only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. He gets this one to Bruce Ellington. And he'll get it down here to the 43. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Again, it's Watson. That's complete to Fuller. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another first. Watson now 12 of 16 thus far. It's first and 10. Watson wants to throw again toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. The pro bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind how it goes so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only the DBs get to throw their verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they got a few words to say to their QB out there.
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're not going to have to.
Underneath for Miller. Now the Eagles with a signal for a timeout as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked.
Partner, I think they saw something there. I mean, they came from the right side deliberately. And you know, there's always a designated guy who goes and blocks it. But it's the rest of his teammates that get him free.
Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball. I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a
Bengals who used the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and nine. Working from the gun, Wentz. He's got Wilson, middle of the field. And on the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver.
He goes full extension, and he's got it. That one good for 16 yards and a first.
And a key number on that play, three. Third play of the drive, third down. Spectacular catch. Turns into a
touchdown. Saves him from the 3-and-out. Now a timeout signal for him. They'll get him with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. It'll be spotted on the right hash. A 52-yard attempt. And Elliott puts this one through. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny, when we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out those All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So we've come to halftime here in Philly with the Eagles on top as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. The weather might be cold, but the playoff races are heating up here on this final Sunday before Christmas. So let's get to it. We'll kick things off with an interconference matchup, the New York Giants on the road at Indianapolis. And it's the Giants who have the lead as they approach halftime. Eli Manning has a touchdown pass. Next, we'll stay in the AFC South. We fly through Kentucky and on down to Nashville. Check on the Tennessee Titans. And they have the lead over the visiting Washington Redskins. Marcus Mariota, 4 touchdown passes. Finally, we'll save the biggest for last. We head to AT&T Stadium to see what's happening with the Cowboys at home in Arlington. And they've got the lead in their matchup with the Tampa Bay Bucs. Dak Prescott has thrown a touchdown pass. In the game you're watching, it's a once again healthy Carson Wentz that's led the way in the first half. He's thrown for over 200 yards already, and his guys have the lead as well. As we get you back to Brandon Guy.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Texans' offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. This is a really doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made. And that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game.
Going again on second and 10. Watson. That'll be taken in by Anderson. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Down! Back 22! Back 22!
Here's Watson, setting up the screen for Miller. Well, he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4.
I love the intelligence the defense just showed there. Read their keys, saw the screen developing, ran to it and smothered it. What a third down stop by them.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Eagles will have great starting field position here as they take over. Carson Wentz and the Eagles make their way out to the field. And he's been effective in their winning, so it makes it a little easier to put a montage together.
It really does, doesn't it? Because we can see him throwing it really well. But how about everything else that's going on? Protection has been excellent. And, of course, the guys catching the ball have provided some highlight reels themselves.
Yeah, I mean, it's not always just one man. He's been good, but you got the guys catching the ball, too.
Yeah, you name it. It's all coming together for them. What they call that synergy? Everything working together really well. And right now, he's the focal point of it.
Over the middle, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no clock,
it's caught. It's Aguilar for the Eagle touchdown. Nelson Aguilar, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Eagles add 6 to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, being on the second half, no matter what. Whether it's first 5 minutes, first 3, whatever. This was a big score to start the second half.
Elliott Good with a PAT. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Heading out is the Texans offense as they get set to take over here. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
Down! Who's waiting?
Throwing again is Watson. Dumps it complete to Miller. And now Miller hit, and he fumbles. And the Eagles have recovered. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up.
In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Nelson Aguilar and company getting set to go again on offense now. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it? Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll force upon him a third and 14.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right to the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Sneaky athletic, do you? That's
no,
just
no.
Kind of a jab in the back.
Yeah, not when it doesn't apply. I think that's a stereotype that needs to be broken down for him.
Throwing his hands. This will be caught at about the 6. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays. Makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? What a really nice game.
Got him out. Turks. Touchdown, Philadelphia. 3 touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz. And the Eagles take advantage of good field position on the turnover to cash this one in. And he's such a talented tight end. Just creates nightmarish tight matchups on the other side.
He's so good that when we say tight end, we're almost damning him with faint praise, aren't we? Because he can do it all. He's as good as any receiver in the NFL.
Well, that's the deal. He's a wide receiver, just in a bigger body.
Bigger body, a matchup nightmare, and who's going to cover it? When I sit in the film session, I just look at the coach and say, really? Really? You're going to yell at me? You go cover it.
Elliott good on the extra point, and the lead is now 24. 3 plays there on that drive. The result? Philadelphia in the end zone. Elliott now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out now comes the Houston offense as you take a look at the playoff picture in the AFC. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly
you
right.
Like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
Tackle made there by Jordan Hicks.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
2nd and 6, just inside the 30.
Green down! Green down!
They'll run it again with Miller. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with 3rd down now looming.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. They'll try to run for it with Miller. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 10 yards there, good enough for a Texan first down.
Yeah, baby. Yeah. Now that's how you start to get back in the good graces of your head coach. Remember, he fumbled on the last possession. How about the faith they showed him, giving him the ball again, and he repaid them, picking up a first down.
Tackle.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. He loses the football a second time. And they're sending a shot in enemy territory at the 45-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who popped it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
And out now come the Eagles. They built up that lead at intermission. And they're just continuing to pour it on right now, aren't they?
Locked into a really good groove right now. I don't know if it's just the play calling. I know the execution is really, really sharp right now. And all the playmakers are doing exactly what you expect. They're making plays. And right now, defense has no answer and no chance of catching up.
Well, they're just looking to turn anywhere for a stop defensively. That one goes for 24 yards. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came out there on the football and catch him off balance.
And he did. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Defensively, celebration time because they finally forced an incompletion. He was perfect throwing the ball to that point.
Yeah, but from his viewpoint, they didn't force the incompletion. He just missed. That's how hot he is right now. That's how he wants to continue to throw the ball.
The tackle that time by Zach Cunningham.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
From the gun on third down, Wentz. Flush to his right. He may try to run for this. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Now, that's disappointing for the defense. They had the advantage, had excellent coverage all over the field, but they let him get away, scrambled, and picked up the first down, and inside the 5-yard line.
It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
He's going to get it running right. And he's in for the Eagles touchdown. J&J, the second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Eagles continue to roll. Well, he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. The bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Elliott good with a PAT, and that will extend this big lead. So the drive here took six plays, and it's capped off by a touchdown run by J&J. Elliott now to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And now out comes Houston. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions. But some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, That's a bad possession all the way around.
You're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Watson now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10.
Watson.
He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Give him 3 on the play, and it'll be a second down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot. Because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. He's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put.
Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. Elsewhere, they have gone to the third quarter now in Dallas. And the Cowboys now, they've opened things up in that one. Dak Prescott, a couple of touchdown passes thus far. On second down, here's Watson. And a catch made, it's Tyler Boyd. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. First target, first catch, and a first down. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 45-yard line. To the air yet again, Watson. Sideline throw is complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. It's a gain of 5, and it'll make it a second down. This should have got more out of that, though. He was wide open.
I love how emphatic you are with that call, because that's exactly what I was thinking. Wide open in the flat. Give him a ball that he can use to get upfield with, not just catch and go over the sideline. They cost themselves some yardage there.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair.
Let's go, D. Down! Black 22! Black 22!
To throw on second is Watson. Oh, back with the line and intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Nigel Brown. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. That's now a second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. We find ourselves here in the midst of a one-sided affair. A lot of field time down the stretch, Mr. Davis.
So we could talk about food, because that is something that you and I enjoy. We enjoy our time at the table. Some of the best steakhouses in the city, but in all seriousness, the performances that we've seen this year, we've seen a bunch of great meat, and it's going to be hard to parse who's going to win the MVP.
Yeah, it really is.
Is it going to be a runner? Is it going to be a thrower? Can a defender finally win it this season? Those are the things that we could probably discuss.
And collectively, this is about as dominant of a performance as you could have hoped for on both sides of the football.
Might have to put it #1 for what we've seen this season.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's a Jay. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Through the contact. Incomplete. You can tell flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Here's Donnie Jones now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. Now a fair catch signaled for and made right about the 43-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Texans will take over with a first and 10. Now the Texans offense, they head back out to do battle here. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Hopkins on the drive over the middle. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well.
Personal foul.
Face mask.
Face mask. Defense.
So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Automatic first down.
Think about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march up another 15 against your squad.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10.
Down. Who waiting? Who waiting?
Now it's Watson. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the second down. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Second and 10 from the 33-yard line.
Down! Who waiting? Who waiting?
On second and 10, Watson. Caught left side, Hopkins. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. Gained 13 yards that time and another first down. It's second and goal.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Back 22!
Here's Watson now on second down. And drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It's way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
Well, they've been so good on third down all day long. Can they convert another here on third and goal? And movement here by one of the Texans up front. In comes the flag.
False start. Offense.
Maybe anticipating a blitz, and they jumped.
Yeah, and if we saw it, you know that they saw it. The bad guys might have been coming on that play. Had to pick them up, and they jumped.
Now Watson on third and goal. This will be caught about the five. And he's able to get it down to the two-yard line. 10 yards gets him closer, but now it's fourth and goal.
Completed pass brings up a fourth down situation.
Do you play analytics on this one? Well, you know, what do your analytics tell you about going for it here? I wonder what they would say.
They tell me you're down by this margin, fourth quarter. You're going. Fairbairn now to attempt the Texan field goal. And remember, he had one blocked earlier. The kick by Fairbairn is good. And the drive will wind up yielding three. Well, in the grand scheme of things, those 3 points likely not going to matter much, but I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And, Charles, we are in the midst of a very one-sided affair. I think this is where you and I have to fill a little bit. You want to regale us with old stories of your childhood in New Paltz, New York?
I don't think anyone wants to hear that, but this is a perfect time for us to start listing MVP candidates, right? The best teams we've seen so far this year, the best games that we've called thus far, how we anticipate the season unfolding. We can go in so many different directions. But the game, certainly not taking us there.
Oh, I hear the remotes clicking off right now.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They fake the give. Now wins. Escaping the pressure right. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 in the first. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now it's a giant. Just shy of 45. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Here we go, here we go.
They run again with a Ajayi. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. So after the run by Jay Ajayi, here's first and 10. They run with Ajayi. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down. Situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, it went against the tendency and ran it, and boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup, and guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try to pick up a first down.
Now a first carry for Donald Pumphrey, and little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Give him a yard on the play, and he's definitely short. It'll be fourth down in a few inches. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule.
Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
They'll go for it. It's Wentz. He's going to have his run back. It's complete. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. They kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it. But in the end, great execution. A 6-yard gain, and it all works out.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and tell him to go like turtle at this point. You just go ahead and play.
Elsewhere, they're into the fourth at Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis. And the Giants are starting to pull away in that one. Eli Manning with 3 touchdown passes to help lead the way. Wentz now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. 1st and 10. Now a handoff looking right. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in most situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration. Not a good play.
So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a 1st and 10. Aguilar, the intended receiver. That'll bring up 2nd down.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield. But when push came to shove, they stood their ground. Now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10.
There we go. Back man. 120.
From the gun, it's Wentz. Sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's 3rd down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things, but once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And here he'll get it down to the 7. A good pickup there, 7 yards, but it brings up 4th down.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the 4th quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down 4th quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They've got a 4th down here in a game that looks to have been decided already. So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And the kick by Elliott is good. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. So it's 3 more points, and that winds this thing out even further here in the 4th.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And they'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Comes a Houston offense as they get set to take over here. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
On
first and 10. Watson. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Hopkins. A good pickup there, a 22. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week trying to get some momentum going.
And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. That one goes for 24 yards. And he's been one of their few bright spots here this afternoon.
And as you pointed out, so far he's gotten his. That's not been the issue at all. But the teammates, the other guys, they've been shut down. That's why the defensive guys have to feel pretty good, even though he's over 100 yards.
Yeah, he topped 100 with that last catch.
Single, single. Hey, green, the line.
From the red zone now, Watson. And he bats it away. Falls down incomplete. Ronald Darby that time, the one who got a hand in and knocked it free.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes that have gone downfield. And that's complete. It's Allington. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Throwing on third down, Watson. Complete.
See, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there. This has been a tough game. Fairbairn able to put this one through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. So this time the protection holds up for him just fine, and he's able to bang it through.
I think their special teams coach got the point across. He gave him a pretty good earful after the block earlier, and this time there's no penetration, so they're able to pick up three.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home. All right? And sometimes you don't win all of them, but they managed to get that done today. Just think about your routine stays the same. Everything's familiar. You feel right going into the game, and they translated that into a win.
They did indeed. They protected the home field, and now the final stages. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a second and 11.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
26.
Heavy, heavy. Here we go.
Oh, look at this. Lynch going to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is it allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he'll be well short of a first down as he stopped again right at the line of scrimmage. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually grab them, moving the ball, and things are working and clicking. They think that they can follow this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Philadelphia, it's a critical win for them as it gets them to 9-6 on the year. And they will hit the road next.